Today's the day we discuss sewing. So if you follow me on Instagram, you will know that throughout lockdown, I have been doing lots and lots of cross stitch. It started with Erica the Prawn. I got into the cross stitch because Mum bought herself a kit and I saw one that kept getting advertised to me on Facebook and I finally caved and bought it. So Mum bought herself a Tunnocks tea cake one. It was really cool. It had the circle with Tunnocks in the middle and the stripes on the edge. And it was one that you could make into a cushion. And I kept being advertised the Prawn from Emily Peacock. So I finally bought it on Etsy. It arrived really quickly and I got into it. And this is what it looked like. I hope I can get it in the right place. That one took me a while. And I think it was mainly because it was my first go. It took me ages to do. And it's the only one that I haven't made a mistake on since doing it because I was so like, oh, must sew correctly. The benefit of the Emily Peacock ones is that they are all counted cross stitch and they're the ones that I've been doing. When you get your kit, you get a pattern like this. It's printed really well, it's good quality, and you use it to find your starting point. So you always go for in the middle, choose the starting point and you start there. Follow the markings and you start right in the middle because it's easier for you to find the middle of the backing fabric than to start on the outside and work your way in. So I think the starting point for the crab, I'm pretty sure I started with this pink square and then I worked my way out and followed the pattern. The patterns work on the premise of tiny squares. So each of these larger squares is 100 stitches, 10 by 10. This allows you to count your stitches really easily. I found it quite easy to use the bigger squares because you knew they were 10. This is the final one in the Under the Sea Creatures. And it took me ages to complete. I did start making a video about this because I'd asked last time I posted a picture, does anyone want a video? I started making it. I hate it, so this is never going to see the light of day. But I think I started making it on the 8th of August and I finished it the Friday before half term. So it took me August, September and October to finish it because I just had too much going on. My original plan for the cross stitches was for in half term that I was locked in isolation for. I was going to work with Mum and we were going to back them and turn them all into cushions. Obviously that didn't happen. So I've only got the two that I was finishing when we moved into this house, which is the beautiful crab and Jade the squid. I do roll them up because I don't want them to have folds in. So this one's a bit rolly. You're supposed to dampen them and iron them into place. This one, I finished this one quite quickly actually. I think it was because it was the summer holidays and I just got into it. I've also done Erica the Prawn, Rebecca the Jellyfish, which was an absolute pain in the ass to do. It was so fiddly. There's so many like odd squares of a colour. It was, oh God, it was a nightmare. Felicity the Lobster. Felicity the Lobster was a car crash because I missed a row in one of the claws. So the whole claw was in the wrong place. So nothing was symmetrical and I had to unpick half of it. It was the worst. When it was finished, amazing. The actual process, hated it so much. I also did Cat the Anglefish. This one was quite easy because it was like the prawn, it had blocks and it wasn't symmetrical, which made life a bit easier. When our isolation began, I had a kit ready and waiting. It's this one. This is the progress I've made on it so far, which is pretty good for a week, I think. I was pretty much doing this solidly for the first week of isolation because I didn't have to work from home. So this is what I did. This bottom bit is going to be the yellow. Then she's got another leg here and a leg either side. And then the background is purple. I've still got quite a lot of that one to do. And the moth's probably going to take me another 10 hours maybe to do the background. Not really sure. When I started doing the crab, I decided I was going to time it and see how long it took me to finish one of these. I won't tell a lie, I gave up timing it halfway through. And I had tried to time it previously, but my clock kept resetting. I did start keeping track of it. Every time I did some sewing, I wrote down the day and how long I spent doing it. So it varies between like 4 hours of sewing to 55 minutes of sewing a day. And that was mostly to do the body. And I added it all up. It took me about 25 hours to do the body and then an extra 10 to like do all the background, because that takes forever. The background takes longer than you think. So obviously you can tell from the sizes of these squares that the cross stitches are a bit different. So if you look at how dense these ones are and compare it to how small these bits are, you can tell what the different thicknesses is. Mentioning the backing fabric, no matter the size of the squares, this stuff is really, really stiff. So you can see at the top of this moth, this is really firm still. And at the bottom where I've been holding it, you can see where I've, you can see in the middle where I've been holding it and sewing and where I folded it up. It's a lot easier to start with the fabric stiff in the middle. Do your first pieces of stitching. Once you have ended the thread and you secured it in place, to then fold it up, literally roll it up like this, and then squeeze it and twist it and soften it up. That's the best way to do it, because remember, you can iron this at the end as well, so it'll be nice and smooth again. These are the threads. So this is the background for the crab. I did not touch this. This is an untouched piece of thread roll. This is the background color for the moth. I'm expecting to not use all of it up. If you buy any of the Emily Peacock kits, which I highly recommend, if you're going into lockdown too, thinking, oh my God, what am I gonna do with all my time? Do some sewing, why not? You end up with a cool thing at the end of it and it keeps your hands busy. I would recommend the Emily Peacock kits. They come with a big bag to store all your equipment in. You know what, why don't we just get one and show you? When you order the kits, they come flat packed in these bags. They also come wrapped in packing paper and they're really secure. You get a bag which is full of all your threads. These are the ones that I didn't actually open because I didn't need to, but I have got loads of leftovers. So here's some more of the back which has been cut. I've got outlines, bits of background, all kinds of things in there left. So I'm gonna have to find some sort of craft to use up all my leftover bits of wool now. And they come with an instruction sheet showing you how to set up threads. They come with needles, and if you're lucky, sometimes they come with a threader. I found that the shipping time was quite fair on the kits as well. I ordered them directly from her website after I boarded the one from Etsy, and they came within a week. They were wrapped really well. And I think they're really good value for money. I mean, yes, they're, I think the kits are about £50, but when you think about how much time it takes to do them, it's like £1 an hour and you end up with something really cool at the end. So if you can afford to get one, I would highly consider it. This one was a bit cheaper. It was done for a charity event and I think they're still available on her website, but there are downloadable patterns as well, which are just the PDFs with the patterns on the back. They haven't got any of the supplies that you need. I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do when I finish them off. I mean, there is a giant squid that I would like to do, but it's very expensive. I think I might ask for it for Christmas instead. And I'm gonna do it and hang it on my wall right above the stairs. It's gonna look great. Anyway, that's it for today. I'm sorry, these videos aren't that entertaining now that I'm actually working from home. I'll do something fun tomorrow, I promise. Bye!